Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jordan and today I'm going to be playing with the Ace Beauty Slice of Paradise palette. I just recently picked up two of their new palettes, the Slice of Paradise and the Blossom Passion, and I'm going to be playing with the Blossom Passion palette in my next video, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, these are so pretty. Like, you know I love me some color and this is right up my alley. It's such a gorgeous palette. Before we get started, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. And yeah, let's just go ahead and jump right in. So I've already gone ahead and done my eyebrows and primed my eyes with my P. Louise base. And I'm just going to apply some tape at the edge because I want the edge to be sharp. Okay, I'm gonna start off by taking the shade Daffodil, which is the bright yellow color, and I'm going to apply that in the inner part of the crease using this ColourPop brush. It doesn't have a name, but it's like a kind of fluffy shadow brush. And right off the bat, that's one of the best yellows I've ever used. It's nice and bright, which I love. Now I'm gonna take the shade Passion Fruit and apply that right beside it. Just packing it on. I'm using an e.l.f. eye crease brush. And I'm just gonna wipe off what's on the brush and take some of the Persimmon shade, which is the lighter orange, and just apply that in the middle of the two to blend them together. Now I'm gonna take the shade Rose Finch, which is this really pretty pink, and apply that right beside the orange shade. And I'm not really worrying about blending them out yet. I'm gonna do that after. And right beside that, I'm gonna take the shade Starling, which is the light purple, and put that on the outer edge. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and blend the edges. I'm actually just gonna take a clean brush and just go over the edges. Okay, so next I'm gonna take the dark purple called Honeyberry and just apply that in the outer corner. Next, I'm gonna take some of the dark blue color called Macaw and put that right beside the purple. Next, I'm just gonna take my P. Louise base and cut my crease halfway until I meet that blue shade. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of the dark blue shade again and just blend that at the edge so it's not like a harsh line, if you know what I mean. Okay, now I'm gonna take the green shade called Kiwi and put that right beside the blue. Okay, now I'm actually gonna take a little bit of the light blue called Bluebell and blend that at the edge of the green, but not applying too much. Okay, and now I'm gonna take the shade Fruit Dove on an e.l.f. concealer brush and apply that to the rest of my lid. Just kind of packing it on there. And this is with a dry brush. And I'm just gonna softly blend that into the blue and the green here at the edge. Okay, I'm just gonna do my face makeup and I'll be right back to do the lower lash line and finish off the look. Okay, so for the lower lash line, I'm just gonna take some of the dark purple shade called Honeyberry and I'm going to blend that in the outer half of the lower lash line. Now on the inner half of the lower lash line, I'm gonna take the shimmer shade called Peacock. Just pop that in there. Okay, I'm just gonna apply mascara and lashes off camera and I'll be right back with my final thoughts. Okay guys, so this is the final look. I used every color except for Flamingo, so I think I did pretty well. So my final thoughts is that this palette, I think, is definitely worth the money. It is really, really good. It's one of the best colorful eyeshadow palettes I've ever used. One of the common problems with colorful eyeshadows I find is that they can sometimes feel like dry and chalky, but these ones are so buttery and like smooth feeling. They're amazing. I had very, very minimal fallout, almost none. I always do my eyes before my face, so it doesn't really matter to me if a palette has fallout. But I know some people really hate it, so I will say that there was barely anything, just a little bit with the purple color. But yeah, I honestly don't have any complaints. The shimmers were really beautiful. They went on really nicely. They're really, really like creamy and smooth. All of the shades are really creamy and smooth. They were so pigmented and true to color. So like what they look like in the pan is definitely what they look like on your eye, which I think is really great, because I hate when you think something is gonna be a certain shade and then you put it on your eye and it looks different. So yeah, I'm honestly super obsessed with this. I will definitely be using it again. I have tried a lot of colorful palettes and this one, it's really, really good. It's like, it's gonna be up there with like one of my favorites now. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.